Hi, welcome back to the second chapter of our product management course. In the last video, we saw a product lifecycle and understood the graph representing the usual ups and downs in a product. Now in this video, we will be discussing the product development process. See, first of all, there are lots of different models and ideology upon which different products are developed. Over the past decades, great people and managers have figured out different models and processes of development. Now as a good manager, you will have to figure out which one is, or maybe which ones are, best for your product. You may even figure out your own model, but that is out of the scope of this program. Now let's start with the first one, Lean Product Development. Now Lean Product Development, or LPD, utilizes lean principles to develop the product. It basically counters the challenges of product development, as a lean product development focuses more on innovation and creating new products. There are different core principles placed with differing priority to that of standard lean production. These are called lean thinking principles. They are define and maximize customer value, identify the value stream and eliminate waste, make the value creating steps flow, empower the team, learn and improve. Next is Agile. Agile is a group of software development methodology based on iterative development, where requirements and solutions evolve through collaboration between self-organizing cross-functional teams. Agile uses incremental iterative work sequences that are commonly known as sprints. Now, Scrum is a framework that falls under Agile methodology, which is the umbrella term for several types of product management approaches to execute complex projects. In this process, we break larger projects into smaller chunks of submodules and execute, review and adapt along the way. Scrum has the following ceremonies and events: sprint planning, daily scrum meeting, sprint review, and sprint retrospective. This is how a typical scrum board looks like. Now, Kanban is a popular framework used to implement agile software development. It requires real-time communication of capacity and full transparency of work. Work items are represented visually on Kanban board, allowing team members to see the state of every piece of work at any time. In Japanese, the word kan means visual and ban means card. So Kanban refers to visual cards. The Kanban is based on three different principles. Visualize the daily workflow, which helps to see all the items in context to each other and can be interrelated. Then limit work in progress. This helps to balance the flow-based approach so teams don't start and commit to too much work at once. And lastly, enhancing the flow. When a module is complete, the next item or task is introduced for the product backlog for development. Now looking at the images of Scrum and Kanban, you will be thinking they look same. Why are we talking about two names and confusing all of us? Well, Scrum and Kanban are not mutually exclusive and not really comparable. In Scrum, there are defined roles, while Kanban says, keep your current roles and responsibilities. Scrum will force you to change your way of working, when Kanban lets you start with your existing process. In Scrum, a clear schedule for events is prescribed by the framework. In Kanban, you don't have events. Yet, they have a lot of similarities. Both are value-centric, team members are respected as bosses of the system, and essentially, they have the same mission: to continuously eliminate waste and remove obstacles. But the beauty of both is that neither is a strict set of rules. There is nothing stopping you from picking up and choosing the best Scrum element for you, such as daily meeting or review. And there is no reason you cannot incorporate a Kanban board into a Scrum. Lastly, waterfall. The waterfall model is method in SDLC framework, Software Development Lifecycle, which is a sequential design process in which progress is seen as flowing steadily downwards, like waterfall, through different phases like feasibility study, requirements analysis and specification, design, coding and unit testing, integration and system testing, and the last phase as maintenance. In a waterfall model, each phase must be completed before the next phase can begin, and there is no overlapping in the phases. With so many different frameworks to choose from, it is your responsibility as a product manager to choose what is best for your product. You can integrate a couple of frameworks together for development process. There are not many limitations here, but there will be some products that can only be done with a particular framework and not with the others. We will look at them in the future when you all be doing your projects and will have to decide which one to choose. That's all for this video. See you in the next video. Until then, keep reading the blogs sent to you mentioned in the material for this video. Thank you.